Let me show you how you can create incidents in For Me ITSM directly from SAP systems. So I've logged into an S4HANA instance where I execute transaction FP50. So I want to post a GL account document, but I get an error message that the posting period is not open. So this is the error that I want to send to the service desk. All I need to do is to go to the help menu and choose create support message. Now the ITSM connector it started and it asks for confirmation to take a screenshot. I will allow this as this is not a sensitive HR or finance transaction. Now the main screen appears where I can enter a subject, a long description. And here at the bottom part of the screen, you have For Me related fields. This is the default template that we deliver where you have the impact, the teams that you have in For Me, and only the SAP related teams are listed here, and a checkbox to mark this ticket as an urgent one. So I will choose medium, urgent, and also I don't have to choose the group myself because the program is smart enough to detect that this transaction, FP50, belongs to the finance module of SAP, and you can set up rules in SAP to map the resolver groups, the teams, to the different transaction code and modules. So in this case, all tickets that are submitted from the finance module are going to end up in the SAP finance team. So I will press the send button and the ITSM connector creates the ticket in For Me ITSM, generates some attachments, uploads everything to that new incident, and then you get a success message with the ticket number. I can also open it with a click. So this is the ticket that was just created. As you can see, the category is incident, but this is customizable. Here we have the impact that we selected. The ticket is marked as an urgent one. The requested by is the SAP user. Additionally, two more fields are populated, the service instance and the configuration item. So this is the SAP system from which I created the incident. As you can see, the ticket is assigned to the finance team automatically based on the current transaction in SAP. Here we have the long description and we have different attachments. So the first big benefit is the automatic routing and categorization of the incident. And the second one is a complete information package that is added to every incident submitted through the ITSM connector. Naturally, we have the screenshot that we allowed the program to take. We have an authorization report, which is the output of transaction SU53, the standard authorization report. That's empty in this use case. I will show you another use case later on where this is populated. I logged in with the super user, so that's why it's empty. We have an Excel sheet, which contains the business context of the problem, meaning that in this column you have all the screen field values that were displayed on the SAP screen. And the program also gathers all the technical details. So you can see that in this program, this screen, this field, which was the document date, the value was today's date. Currency was US dollars. Document type was SA, which is GL account document. The company code was 1710 and so on. So everything is captured and attached in a structured format along with the technical details. The last attachment in this example is a PDF file, which contains a header with the affected user and system information on all the user input. And now comes the really interesting part, because the program captures all the details of the currently running SAP program, like the title, the transaction code, program name, screen number, subscreen number, component, package, and so on. All the details of the last error message are added here. The message number, class, type, even the message source code position, so you can directly jump to this source code up to line 420, and that's where this error message is issued to the user, so you can check out why this happened. You also have the long text coming from the SAP help. We have information on the SAP client. This was an SAP GUI for Windows with this version from that laptop and so on. All the details of the SAP backend user are here all the details of the SAP system, including database details, kernel information, version numbers, and so on. And the last section contains a list of components with version information that are installed in the system. So having all this information immediately available will reduce the ticket resolution time significantly, because the support teams don't have to get all this information from the end user. They don't have to ask for a screenshot, for an authorization report, and all the details of the SAP transaction and the contents of the screen. It's easy to reproduce the problem and to work on a solution. Additionally, the routing and categorization is done in an automated way, so you can basically bypass the service desk and get your tickets assigned to the relevant team automatically.